Good afternoon. I have already done an offline video. Please go to the offline video. This book is one of the best books. It is a soft copy is given back to you. The hard copy is also available in the college library. My suggestion is you can go for buying this book. This book and another book I yet to search, find it out. That is Peter Lynch. That is one of the best book. And then is another book, Kohubi. Kohubi, I already given the soft copy. All the finite state machine related part you can get only in the Kohubi's book. There is no such book up there. And for the language part, that is, this book is one, a good book. And then Peter Lynch's book is also a very good book. And I have given the soft copies other books. Peter Lynch I have yet to find. Peter Lynch's book is available in the library. My suggestion is you go for the standard books which is followed by IITs, because whenever you appear to be gate, and then you the questions will come from this book only. Don't buy book any Indian author. That is very few authors are very good. It is better to buy the read the international books, because most of the IITs are following international books. Okay. Any question you can put, because this is now online class. You can anytime take your microphone and put your questions. Thank you. Now this book and other books, and I'll give always the notes and PPT beforehand. Books I'll give and notes so you can have. So I have already told you, right now in your second year computer science, you know the C programming. Some of you have already know the programming. But what is the limit of the programming? That the automata will define. So you cannot program everything and everything. So before start programming, you need algorithm. That algorithm dictates your programming language choice, and not only, and also data structure. And which platform you are working. See, if you are working on Android, maybe more Kotlin or Java, or if you have a CPU, then it may be C, Java, Python. So your programming language doesn't matter at all. Whatever we thought that, whether some of you have questions that whether you should go for C, whether you should for Python, whether you should for Java. Actually, thing is, the basic code thing is algorithm. And another interesting thing is, not every problem has algorithm. That I want to tell again and again. That is, one portion is, that is automata codes. We will tell you not only complexity, because complexity, you have fair idea what is complexity is, like selection sort, you have, even the base case, you have O n square. Worst case also O n square. Insertion sort, base case is O n, bubble sort is O n. So that is what is like the stupidest part of this selection sort, because it can get the complexity term. But complexity means when you can program. But if you cannot program, that is lots of functions are there like uncomputable. Because what will happen maybe tomorrow, we don't know. We have the best of the computers we have, but we cannot know. Say, this is the COVID-19 case. Nobody has predicted, except Bill Gates probably 5 years back. He has given him, we have lots of computers, nobody predicted. Even now, how the COVID-19 second attack, second phase in India concept is very difficult. So, not every program is computable, but we are trying, we are approximating and all these things. So, the automata is such a computer, basic fundamental computer science topic that we distinguish between algorithm and program, that we already covered. But whether algorithm, the complexity, the sum of the complexities I have told you, the polynomial type complexity. What the polynomial type complexity is, the number of item in n. If it is O n, like linear search in an array, you want to find which is the maximum, like O n. And that you have to go the nth element, like in a binary search, if in a binary tree the all the numbers are loaded, then you want to find which way, you have to find the number, you go to the midpoint, and if you say greater, if the number is greater, then you go to the right of midpoint, and then you go like this. It is a binary search, you know the complexity is log n. So that is the improvement from A to log in. Improvement, but you have to put the number data in the binary search tree. Then the March sort, you know, instead of ON square, you go ON log N. This is pretty good. N square algorithm, you know, N cube, maybe matrix multiplication. This is good. N to the power certain matrix computations are there. Even N to the power 100 problem will cause an easier problem. Though it is difficult to find beyond N to the power 4. These are called polynomial problem when N goes in the base. But when N goes to the power, then it is a, we call a exponential problem, not polynomial problem. Don't say it's a non-polynomial. No, it is an exponential problem, 2 to the power N problem. Like this one, it is this exponential problem. So this is a typical Tower of Hanoi problem. You have to shift all the disks to another bar, and with some, so that you cannot put lower higher diameter than lower one. So how many tries you can do, and this is the number of transfer disks to the power of n. So if you have n disk, you need 2 to the power n. Here you have 8 disks, so 2 to the power 8 minus 1. So this is the first example of the problem which is a computable exponential problem. Then one problem is traveling salesman problem. Another problem I used to tell you that I have not discussed in my earlier lecture, that is called scheduling problem. Say in the COVID-19 cases, they are taking an example Ambi. Ambi shortly. There are several emergency ICCU, CCUs, and there are several nurses. The nurses maybe giving the morning duty or afternoon duty or night duty. So how to schedule your nurse to aspire the requirement of your rooms and all these things? This is one of the very hardest problems. Believe me, your routine is also a very hard problem. It is not to be the boring problem, it's much harder. So any faculty, right now you show me now, I'm Shubhik sir taking a routine, giving a routine. So it is that SIC should be 2+ together, or there should be back end and all these things. Right now it is easier because it's an internet, because whenever there's a classroom, the classroom has to be, you have to book classroom, you have to book teacher, you have to book group. You should not have in the last class and all these things. Lots of restrictions, that is called scheduling restrictions. This is called the scheduling problem, and scheduling problem goes everywhere, from the nurses problem, or you say the routine assignment for any engineering colleges or management colleges, or where classroom date, students maybe like now you might difficulty in the next year, you have the optional subject, how to allocate optional subject, teachers, faculty room. This is called scheduling problem. This is one of the toughest problems, even if it is solvable. But it is basically solvable, but it is not a direct algorithm. Like it is a pattern matching, but you have to bring it whether it matches or not. It is sometimes a brute force algorithm, it takes quite amount of time. Maybe greater than 2 to the power n, like factorial traveling salesman problem, it is a factorial n into 2 to the power n. These are called hard problems. Hard problem. So automata theory, you give an introduction what is problem, and there are some problems and there are lots of problems also which is not solvable and declared by the computer scientist, like it is not solvable, like Turing halting problem. Say the Turing machine, you just take it from granted, you know, still now the best powerful machine other than quantum computing. Even the quantum computer comes, there are lots of similarities in this. So let me see if the time permits, I'll go into the problem. Anyway, Turing machine, Alan Turing devised in 1936, a paper strip and a head, reading and writing head go one step left or one step right. But any problem which you can write algorithm, that can be solved by that machine. The programs comes into the squares, and the data is also to come to the state, and the one finite state machine with hard, I come, what is finite state machine? With reading and writing head, it just read and write, go only one step forward or one step backward, cannot steal on this space, it cannot. So that is the problem. If you have any algorithm, Turing machine is a problem. That is great. Now nobody has thought it before. So he is it's almost like Albert Einstein's like figure in computer science. So everywhere he come again, Turing and again. So there are lots of great computer scientists who cover up in this automata, formal language and automata theory. And what I'm going to say, it is Turing-Halting problem. Turing-Halting problem says that you cannot design an algorithm. You cannot design a program that the algorithm program is saving here, so that it can take any program into input, and it will say the program will stop or not, or the program will halt or not. If it says that it will halt or it will not, okay. But if you're deciding on whether it is halting or not, it is infinite loop, that is called halting problem. And till now, this is one of the undecidable problems, that it is true. You cannot design, basically what is the output? What is the output? You cannot design a program which can solve all problems. That's true. So there are all problems, there are some problems. Some problems do not have algorithm. That is called uncomputable problem. There are also, you can how much uncomputable is there? That is the interesting of the computer science. That is the reason the computer science is young science, because it hardly comes 1936 paper. It is still not 100 years have passed. So is other the engineering, say civil engineering, mechanical, electrical, they are more than 100 years old. It is not that young field, and it can solve all the problems. And right now if you see the lockdown and all these things, computer science can solve all the some of the problems, not all the problems. Some problems are always unsolvable. It's cool. So there is some brute force algorithm. You always what is the brute force? Because most of the day of the time, even we solve our brute force algorithm. That is brute force algorithm. It is what is the difference between algorithm and process? Whenever I say the tiling problem, or whenever I in a piece of paper, I write the formal language and automata theory for 2024 or 2023 section A, I write it. Then I pieces it in 32 pieces or 64 pieces, and then I want to put it together. Then I have to put it, I take one, then I have to take the another 31 pieces so that it matches. So that the whole tiling problem, the whole letter comes, whole the picture comes. So this is a process. This is a task. But you cannot say algorithm. What is the difference between algorithm and process? Well, algorithm must be shorter. So if you have 1,000 pieces or if you have 31 pieces, I should check it with 5 pieces, 6 pieces, 8 pieces, and that can generalize 30 pieces. If I take every piece together and check it, then whenever you go for your program size depends on your number of your items, then you can't call it a program. You can call it program, but you cannot call it algorithm. Sorry. So you can call a program. Okay. Program doesn't say that, but algorithm means it cannot go loop. It has some input statement, input data, it's some output data, and it should not depend on size of your problem. That is the main difference between algorithm and program. Program it can, but it cannot say it's an algorithm. It's a brute force. Okay. So that is it. I have told this is a clever technique like a backdate. Brute force I have already covered. I will cover it. These are the techniques. Let's quickly, this I have covered in my earlier videos. These are the techniques. Yeah, this is very interesting. So till now, n cube, these are the polynomials. These are called the easy problems. Say easy, and then it is called the difficult, 2 to the power n. There's our tower of NI problem, then the factorial n in the traveling salesman problem, and then the n to the power n problem. I'll come. There are lots of problems, but they're very interesting problems. That is, they can be converted, but they're the brightest computer minds that they are doing it. Yeah, this is time complexity. Whenever you have algorithm, then you can calculate the time complexity, and that's it. But whenever there are sometimes non-computable problem also, that's the thing. Yeah, this is, I think we have covered in a data structure class, algorithm definitely covered, and do not want to say, this is GCD, Great Common Divisor, this is the algorithm, one of the first known algorithms. covered. This is I have already covered. Tower of Honor I have covered. This is I have covered. Selections or insertions or regarding undecided meeting. This is uncomfortable problem, that is a during halting problem. And this is a tiling problem I wish to mention. One thing I must say here, this thing I will cover in my tomorrow's class is possible. This is a Turing machine. This is, I'm jumping to the Turing machine today, right? Because this is our end chapter. Turing machine is very simple. Turing machine is single tape, and tape is block either 0 or 1, or it is 0 and 1 is called the alphabet, okay, the symbol. And zero, there is no other thing, 0 and 1, so these are called alphabet, we call it a sigma. And see, alphabet consists of two symbols, 0, we first, second bracket open, second bracket in, 0, comma 1. So what are the first thing you have learned is set. Set is very required for your alphabet. So that is great, Cantor has developed, and that is great. That is till 1874, that is Rabindranath is 14 years old, he is preparing to go to UK. So till that, the set is not involved. Set is not, nobody has discovered. The great Cantor has discovered set, and in fact, it's more popular in this whenever David Hilbert, another great mathematician who stands for it in 1900. So this is the development time, 1974 to 1990s, the set theory comes. Set is unordered collections, and you can have a lot of computations on it. That is a great thing. So what is the set? Set is the first you have to symbols, like our computers, digital hardware can understand 0 and 1. The symbols is 0 and 1, and then we call alphabet. Alphabet is 0 and 1, consisting of symbol. Then you can have it for meaningful string. That is concatenation of zeros and on. If certain strings are, say, if they are meaningful of, meaning is 00 has no meaning, but 10 and 01 has meaning, and 11 has no meaning. So 10 is accepted by a hardware, or 01 is accepted by a hardware. It's like exclusive of, then it called it a language. This concatenation of symbol or string is called language. So if the exclusive OR gate understand only 10, it gives 1, or 01, it gives 1. If it gives 00, it 0 and 1 are also 0. So that is the meaningful of a sentence. Sentence is nothing but concatenation of symbols with the meaning. So that is the fundamental thing of our programming language. The programming language, a lot of other features. First of all, programming language is an approximation of our spoken language. Spoken language is very, very tough. I will tell you it is a type 0 language. I will cover what is type 0. Much better approximation is written English language. It takes English as a standard one. So English language, you see there are some noun phrase, verb phrase. So there is some grammar into it. Then if you more simplify it, you will get like a Python-like language. Also Java is there. Python, there is a readable, more or less a readable language, but still it is there, it is not a formal language. These are called programming language. You see, but they are all building block is formal language. So what is formal language? Formal language is all the characteristics, 99.9 characteristics of programming language, but it's much, much simpler form, and you have a fewer rules, and your alphabets are your 0 or 1 or A to Z. So, but you can solve any problem with the formal language. So formal, so that is the our course is. Course is what you understand, theory of computation. Like you have to write a, if you understand the problem, if there is an algorithm, you have to write it in programming instruction. That programming instruction maybe in Python, Java, that is almost 1:1 compatible with formal language. The formal language, you write the program, and that has to be run on a machine. One machine. Machine, I have told it is not a great machine or like a drilling machine. The machine is a mechanistic thing. It can be your 0 and 1 switch that is called combinatorial circuit, or it may be with some feedback with the finite state machine. Finite state machine can remember only state. It doesn't have any stack. Stack is very useful. So with this finite state machine, in our next few classes, we'll try to go into the what are the finite state machine, different types of machine. Then if we put into a stack that is called push-down automata, then subsequently Turing machine, so we'll solve it. So till now, today, whatever I have covered, I will again go back. I know it is one of the toughest course. Please feel free, offline, online, anytime. You can read.